हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व सम एडवांस प्रॉब्लम फॉर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जामिनेशन. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. एन अनसेचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन ए हैविंग फॉर्मूला C6H10 रेडली गिव्स बी ऑन ट्रीटमेंट विद सोडामाइड इन लिक्विड अमोनिया. इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ लिक्विड अमोनिया व्हेन बी इज अलाउड टू रिएक्ट विद 1-chloropropane अ कंपाउंड सी इज ऑब्टेंड ऑन पार्शियल हाइड्रोजिनेशन. In presence of Lindlar's catalyst, C gives D, having formula C9H18, and on ozonolysis of this D gives 2,2-dimethylpropanol and 1-butanol. With proper reasoning, give the structure of A, B, C and D. So first of all, for such type of question, you have to assign the roadmap, a rough roadmap by which we can understand easily the sequence of reaction which is represented, which is shown in the question. So what is happening in this case? First of all, an unsaturated hydrocarbon, that is A, having formula C6H10, this is A. What is happening? Readily gives B on treatment with sodamide. So when it is treated with sodamide, that is NaNH2 and liquid ammonia, what is happening? There will be formation of B will be taking place. So B compound will be obtained. Further, this B is allowed to react with 1-chloropropane. So there will be formation of C compound is taking place. On the partial hydrogenation, in the presence of Lindlar's catalyst, this C gives D. So this is Lindlar's catalyst. In the presence of Lindlar's catalyst, it is giving the compound, that is C9H18. So this is represented as D. So further, what is happening? Further, on ozonolysis of this D compound, so what is happening? When this D compound undergo ozonolysis, so there is a formation of two compound is taking place. One is 2,2-dimethylpropanol. So what will be the formula of this compound? 2,2, it means CH3 C double bond OH. So this is 2,2-propanol, and there is formation of another compound. What is another compound? That is 1-butanol. So what is 1-butanol? Double bond HCH2CH2CH3. So this is 1-butanol. So this is the hint which is given in the question. So by the help of ozonolysis, but that is the product which is obtained by the help of ozonolysis, by combining this product, we can identify what will be this compound that is represented as D. So let's see, when we combine these two products, so what is happening in this case? So what is happening in this case? If we remove the oxygen of these carbonyls, so there will be double bond formation will be taking place between this carbon and this carbon. The formula of the compound which will be obtained after joining of these ozonolysis product. So there will be double bond formation between these two carbon, CH and CH2 CH2 CH3. So if this compound is correct, so further on ozonolysis, this compound will give back these two products. So if this compound is correct, it will give on ozonolysis the similar product which is represented in the question. So let's see, 2CH3. So this is the compound. So we roughly assigned the compound by joining these two products. So if this compound is correct, so further on ozonolysis, this will give back these two aldehydes. So what is happening? So ozonolysis is taking place in the two steps. So first step, there is reaction with ozone in the presence of inert solvent, and the temperature of the reaction is 196 Kelvin. So there is cleavage of this double bond is taking place. So there is formation of ozonoid compound will takes place. So what is ozonoid? this compound will be taking place. We know that this compound is highly unstable. So what is happening in this case? This compound is highly unstable. So there will be breaking of bond will be taking place. This oxygen will be removed and there is formation of carbon double bond in this position and in this position. So what is happening? There will be formation of two aldehydes taking place, which is similar to these product which is represented in the question. It means this compound is correct. So further, what is happening? In the presence of zinc dust and water, this is reductive cleavage. So this zinc dust will be removed in the form of ZNO because this zinc will combine with this oxygen. So what is happening? There will be formation of CH3 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 CH double bond O. So this is one compound, and second compound is this position, C double bond O H CH2 CH2 CH3. So these two compounds are correct. It means the first, that is this D compound, is correct. So what will be the IUPAC name of this compound? So in this case, numbering will be done from this position, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So what will be the name of this compound? It is 2,2-dimethyl. What will be the chain of this compound? That is heptane, and double bond position is at third carbon. So hept 3,ene. What is the next compound which can be easily identified by observing this roadmap? That is C. This C is undergoing partial hydrogenation in the presence of Lindelar's catalyst, and we know that this Lindelar's catalyst will only react when there is a triple bond is present in the compound. So when there is a triple bond, hydrogenation will take place in the presence of Lindelar's catalyst. Because of that, there will be formation of alkene will take place. So it means this must be alkyne. So what will be the structure of this compound? As we have identified the structure of this alkene is having double bond in this position. It means this C compound will also having triple bond in this similar position, which on further partial dehydrogenation is giving this D compound. So what will be the structure of this C? CH3 C CH3 CH3 C, triple bond C CH2 CH2 CH3. So this must be the alkyne, that is C, which is undergoing hydrogenation in the presence of palladium, which is supported by BSO4 and poisoned by sulfur. So the reaction will stop at alkene's stage. Because of that, there will be formation of CH3 C CH3 CH3 C, H double bond CH CH2 CH2 CH3. It means this D compound will be obtained. So if we carefully observe the structure of this compound C, we can easily identify compound A and B. So what is happening in this case? This chloropropane is reacting with B. It means in this case, three carbons are coming from this chloropropane, whereas this B is having carbon number 6. So what is happening in this case? There will be this NaNH2 in the presence of liquid ammonia will only react when there is a presence of a terminal alkyne is taking place. When terminal alkynes are present, we know that in the case of terminal alkyne, there is acidic hydrogen, and when there is acidic hydrogen, it means sodium will take the position of hydrogen. Because of that, carbon sodium bond will become polar, due to which polarity of this carbon sodium bond, it will further react with this one chloropropane. Then only the carbon chain will increase. So what is happening? It means these are the two compounds. Because this starting material A is alkyne and it is also terminal alkyne. So in the case of terminal alkyne, there will be hydrogen is present. So if this bond will be broken, so there will be formation of chlorine at this place. So this is one chloropropane, and this carbon will attach with the hydrogen. It means the starting material is this alkyne, which is reacting with sodium amide. So there is formation of polar bond is taking place at this carbon position. So this carbon will bond with the sodium. Because of that polarity of the bond, this will easily react with this alkyl halide. So what is happening? C triple bond CH. So it will be the starting compound, that is this alkyne. This is terminal alkyne. So because of the acidic hydrogen, it will easily react with Na, NH2 in the presence of liquid ammonia. C, CH3, C triple bond CNA. Because of that, there is high polarity of bond is taking place. Because of that, there is separation of charges. It means positive charge will come on this sodium, negative charge will come on this carbon. So due to the polarity of the bond, it will easily react with, that is, one chloropropane. Because of the electronegativity difference between the carbon and halogen, this carbon is having partial positive charge, halogen is having partial negative charge. Because of that, this carbon ion will attack on this carbon, which is electron deficient, due to which there will be increase of, that is, higher alkyne will be obtained. So what is happening? There will be formation of CH3, 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 C triple bond CH2, CH2, CH3, and this is a C compound. So this is a C compound, so all the compound, and this is B, which is reacting with this one chloropropane. So this is B compound, which is highly reactive because of the polarity of carbon sodium bond. So these are the compound which are formed during this reaction. Now, second question: a conjugated alkadiene having molecular formula C13H22 on ozonolysis yielded ethyl methyl ketone and cyclohexane carbaldehyde. Identify the diene, write its structural formula, and give its IUPAC name. So this is alkadiene. It means in this case there will be presence of 2 pi bond is taking place in this compound, which is having formula C13H22. It means there are 13 carbon and 22 hydrogen. So what is happening on ozonolysis? So first of all, draw the rough roadmap of this reaction. So what is happening? Compound is having formula C13H22, which on ozonolysis, so there will be formation of cyclohexane carbaldehyde and ethyl methyl ketone. So what will be the formula? CH3 CH2 C double bond O CH3. This is ethyl methyl ketone. Second, what is happening? There is formation of cyclohexane carbaldehyde. So it means cyclohexane, in which the carbon of the functional group is not included in the cyclic ring. It is outside the cyclic ring. It is excluded. So it will be represented as a carbaldehyde. So this is a carbaldehyde. There are 4 carbons in this and 7 carbon. It means there will be formation of 2 carbon compound is also taking place during the ozonolysis. And we know that in the case of ozonolysis, there will be always formation of aldehydes or ketone will be taking place. When we join these 2 compounds, there is 2 carbon less from the starting material, and we know that in the case of ozonolysis, there will be either formation of ketone is taking place or aldehyde. So what will be the compound? Second, calculate the number of hydrogen. How many hydrogens are less in this case? In this case, there are 8 hydrogen. In this case, this is CH2, 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 and in this position there is 1 hydrogen. There are 12 hydrogen in this case and 8 hydrogen in this case. So how many hydrogens are left? there are two hydrogens are left because the total number of hydrogen is 20. And the starting material is having hydrogen 22. It means the compound which is not represented in the reaction is having two carbon and two hydrogen. And we know that in the case of ozonolysis, there will be always a formation of aldehyde is taking place. It means in this case, there will be carbonyl compound, that is C double bond O is present. So what will be the compound? In this case, this compound is glyoxal. This is glyoxal. So let's see what will be the product which will be obtained if we remove all the oxygen. So there will be formation of CH3C, CH2, CH3, double bond C, H, single bond H, double bond C, H, cyclo. Hexane. So this compound, that is, this is the starting material which is represented, which is having formula C13H22. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it means this is hexene chain, and this will be treated as side branch, and this methyl is also treated as side substituent. So what will be the IUPAC name of this compound according to the alphabetical order? In alphabetical order it will come before, so this is cyclohexyl, comma, this is present at the first position, 1-cyclohexyl, next fourth position, 4-methyl. Next, the name of the chain, hex, 1, 3, 1, 3-diene. Now, next problem, chloro compound with molecular formula C3H3Cl show the following property. First, decolorize bromine in CCl4. Second, absorbed hydrogen catalytically. Gave a precipitate with ammonical cuprous chloride solution. Deduce the structure of this chloro compound. Hint is given within the question. In the first case, as you can see, so first of all, write the compound. What is the molecular formula of this compound? C3H3Cl. So what is happening in the case of bromine? The red orange color of bromine is decolorized. So this is a test for unsaturation. It means there is either presence of double bond or triple bond. Next, in this case there is double bond or triple bonds are present. So there is addition of hydrogen will takes place in the presence of catalyst. Next point, gave a precipitate with ammonical cuprous chloride solution. So in this case there is formation of precipitate is taking place in the presence of CuNH3 whole twice OH. So this complex, this compound, this solution will only react when there is a presence of terminal alkyne. So in the case of terminal alkyne, there is acidic hydrogen is present. Only in that case, the reaction will takes place. It means in this case, there this is not alkene, this is alkyne. And it is also terminal alkyne. It is not non-terminal alkyne, because in the case of non-terminal alkyne, there is no acidic hydrogen. It means in the case of non-terminal alkyne, reaction with this ammonical solution of cuprous chloride will not take place. Compound is having formula CH2Cl, C triple bond CH. Then only, if this is the formula, then only these three reaction will takes place by this compound. So if we represent all the three reactions first, so what will be the reaction? In the presence of Br2 and CCl4, decoloration of Br2 will takes place. So what is the color of this Br2? Red orange color. So when there is formation of halogenated product will be taking place. So in this case, 4 bromine atom will attach because there are 2 pi bonds. So there is tetrahalogenated product is obtained in the case of alkyne because there are 2 pi bonds are present. So this compound, that is the solution which will be left, is colorless. Presence of hydrogen there will be hydrogenation will takes place in the presence of catalyst. Catalyst can be any catalyst. So what is happening in this case, there will be formation of CH2CH3 will takes place. So in this case 2 mole of hydrogen will be taken because there are 2 pi bonds next. In third case, what is happening? This ammonical solution is reacting because in this case there is acidic hydrogen is present. So what is happening in this case? When this compound ClCH2, C triple bond CH in the presence of copper NH3 hole twice, this is the complex OH. So what is happening in this case? There will be formation of ClCH2, C triple bond C, Cu will takes place, is present as red precipitate. Now next question, the alkyl halide having formula C4H9Br, which is represented as A, react with alcoholic KOH and gives an alkene, which is represented as B, which react with Br2 to form dibromide represented as C. This dibromide is transformed with sodamide to give gas which is represented as D, which form precipitate when it is passed through ammonical silver nitrate solution, give a structural formula of compound A, B, C, D and explain the reaction involved. So first of all, before identifying what will be the compound, draw the roadmap of the reaction which is represented in the question. So what will be the roadmap? First of all, the starting material is A, Br, this is A, this is represented as A, which react with alcoholic KOH. This react with alcoholic KOH, because of that there will be formation of B is taking place. This is alkene. So this is alkene which is represented as B. Further, this B compound on reaction with Br2 in the presence of CCl4, on reaction with Br2 in the presence of CCl4, there is formation of C compound is taking place, and this C is dibromide. This is dibromide. Further, what is happening? This C compound in the presence of sodamide, that is NaNH2, in the presence of sodamide give compound. Further, this gas, that is D, when passed over the ammonical silver nitrate solution, that is Tollens reagent having formula AgNH3 whole twice OH. So this is Tollens reagent. So let's see whether the starting structure which I have assigned is correct or not, but the formula of this compound is matching with this compound. So what is happening? Further, in the presence of alcoholic KOH, so in the presence of alcoholic KOH, there is dehydrohalogenation is taking place. It means removal of HBr. We know that this position of carbon is alpha carbon. So the hydrogen of beta carbon will be removed. So there will be formation of double bond will takes place at this position. So this will be CH3, CH2. It is represented as B. This compound alkene will react in the presence of Br2. So what is happening in the presence of Br2 and CCl4? There will be attachment of bromine atom will takes place on the carbon which are attached by the double bond. So what is the compound which will be formed? CH3, CH2, CH, CH2, Br, Br. In the presence of NaNH2. So what is happening in the presence of NaNH2? We know that NaNH2 is the better base in comparison to alcoholic KOH. This is also following dehydrohalogenation. It means in the presence of NaNH2, there is dehydrohalogenation is taking place. There are two bromines are attached. It means there will be removal of 2 HBr will takes place when 2 moles of NaNH2 are taken. So what is happening in this case? There will be formation of CH3. CH2, C triple bond C, H will takes place, because this bromine and one hydrogen will be removed. Similarly, this hydrogen, the carbon which is having two hydrogen, one of the hydrogen of this carbon will be removed with this bromine. So it means there will be formation of two double bond, that is two bi bond is taking place, and this is butyne and it is present in the gaseous state. This is a terminal butyne, so the D compound, so this compound is D, that is terminal butyne, and this is existing in the form of gas. So this compound, that is dihalogenated compound, is C. Next, further, this compound, that is alkyne, when reacted in the presence of tolerance reagent, which is having formula AgNH3 whole twice OH. So what is happening in this case? There will be formation of this. In this case, this is terminal alkyne. So in this case, there is acidic hydrogen is present, and we know that this tolerance reagent will only react when there is terminal alkynes are present or acetylenes is present, because in the case of terminal alkyne, this hydrogen is acidic. So this hydrogen will be replaced by silver. So only terminal alkynes are giving this reaction. And this terminal alkyne will be only obtained when the starting material is having this structure. It means this structure is correct. It means the starting material, that is a starting reactant having formula C4H9Br, which is represented as A, is correct. So when this alkyne will be passed over this tolerance reagent, so there will be replacement of this acidic hydrogen will takes place, and the formation of CH3CH2C triple bond CAG will takes place. So what is happening? And removal of byproduct will be H2O and 2NH3 molecule. So this compound will be obtained, and this compound is present in the form of precipitate. This is white precipitate, which is obtained only when there is a terminal alkynes are present.